for the 1,000th time. Gwe Akipjilidok, hello and welcome to the Rath Eastlink Community Center, the Community Credit Union Arena, for this morning's game between the Halifax Wolverines and the New Scotland Storm. This is game number 13 of the 2023 Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey Provincial Championship. It is also my 1,000th broadcast, and I am so honored to be able to hit that milestone with these two teams today, the Wolverines and the Storm. Let's send things downstairs for some pregame introductions. Let's take a closer look at this matchup, but before we do that, we must take a moment to acknowledge that the Rath Eastlink Community Center, the town of Truro, and the entire region covered by the Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League, which is what we now know as the province of Nova Scotia, all lie within the ancestral unceded territory of Mi'kma'ki. Taking a look at this matchup, it is the 3-0 New Scotland Storm with a chance to possibly finish first in the incomplete round robin. If they win their game and if Truro wins their game at 12 o'clock, both teams would be 4-0. Then we'd have to go and look at tiebreakers based on goal ratios. For Halifax, they are 1-1-1, so 3 points through three games. They have a chance to guarantee themselves a spot in the semifinals if they can get at least a victory in this game. If they get a tie, then they will need some help. If they lose this game, they will need some help. They can still get into the semifinals, but they'll need the Truro Bearcats to beat the Jonald Jim Cougars if their game ends in a tie or with a loss to the New Scotland Storm. We'll give you this information on the starting goaltenders in just a moment as we are underway here at the Rath Eastlink Community Center. A shot there gets blocked by Bent. He tries to get it ahead to Uzuchukwu. It gets beyond him. Comes to Lopez at the line. His shot gets blocked by Branton. And now Gallant will play it down into the corner. Bent will be the first one there for the Wolverines, who are in their home whites with the black and gold trim. Wolverines ice the puck with 26 seconds gone. Starting goaltender for the Wolverines in today's game will be Jordan Rittenberg. He makes his third start of the tournament. He has a record of 1-1 to this point, a 2.0 goals against average, and a 9.02 save percentage. His victory was a shutout over the Novas. He also played in the loss to the Cougars. The Wolverines, as mentioned, 1-1-1. They lost to the Cougars 4-3 in their opening game, bounced back with a 4-0 win over the Novas, finished off yesterday's action with a thrilling 2-2 tie against the Bandits to get them to their 3 points so far in three games. McLeod brings the puck back in across the line. It rolls into Rittenberg. We're going to get our first penalty of the game coming up as soon as the Wolverines touch the puck. Puck comes out to center. Sanford will play it across for Thomas Kluwit. He'll back up with it. Gets it across to Sanford. And just like yesterday, A couple minutes into the first period of the second game of the day, we get a change in the lighting. Odd that it happens at the same time both days. We're going to get the penalty against the Wolverines, so the Storm will go to the power play. Their power play so far this weekend, 12.5% efficiency, as they are 1-for-8. The penalty kill of the Wolverines is at 90%, as they have killed off 9 of 10 shorthanded situations so far here this weekend. And the penalty is a hooking call at 1:02 of the first period. And we'll talk about the Storm goaltender. We still haven't gotten to the Storm starting goaltender yet. We'll get to him in a moment. But right now the puck is cleared down the length of the ice. And now we can mention, why not? He just touched the puck. Will Cole gets the start. Cole has played, I think, every minute so far for the New Scotland Storm, I do believe. Yes, he is 3-0. He's got a 2.5 goals against average and a .943 save percentage. Getting the victories 5-2 over the Novas, 5-1 over the Cougars, 5-2 over the Bandits. And there's actually a miscalculation on his goals against average there. His goals against average should actually be 1.67, not 2.50. Little error on the league website there, but we got that corrected. The save percentage is accurate at .943. Here's MJ Bottomley with the puck. He'll play it over to Bent. Bent will get it down the length of the ice, and they'll kill off a little bit more of the Storm power play. 42 seconds and counting left to go in that. Sanford able to get the puck across over to McLeod. McLeod gets it in across the blue line. Simonson able to get it there, and he'll send it back down the length of the ice. It'll roll right in onto Cole, and Cole settles it there for Sanford. Player Sanford gets the pass ahead for McLeod. McLeod will feed it to Owen O'Donnell, who brings it in across the line, fires a shot, Rittenberg to save, and he will hang on for a faceoff. 18 seconds left in the penalty, 12:16 left to go here in the first period. And like we mentioned a few times before, it's worth mentioning again, we do like to try and be interactive here on our broadcast. Please, if you want to share your thoughts on the game, let us know by sending us a tweet at Petter, P-E-T-T-E-R, as in my last name, Michael Petter, P-C underscore sports, that's P-E-T-T-E-R, P-C underscore sports, is the handle at Twitter, or through Facebook, go to Facebook.com, and then search Petter Sports and Screaming, and you can reach us there. Ozuchukwu gets bumped off of the puck, it'll roll in onto Owen O'Donnell, he'll start to work his way ahead as the penalty comes to an end. O'Donnell brings the puck in across the blue line, takes it down towards the corner. Now he'll play it back to the line. Scotland, his shot gets deflected up into the air and goes over the net, over the glass, into the netting, and we'll get a stoppage with 11:47 left to go here in the first period. Faceoff will be to the right of Jordan Rittenberg in the Halifax net. One of the first times I saw Rittenberg play goal was earlier this year when the Halifax Wolverines were in the championship game of the Monctonian. Proctor with a backhand shot, that goes wide. Rittenberg had quite a game backstopping the Wolverines to that championship. And the Wolverines looking to add some more hardware if they can get themselves into the semifinals. And they will be playing, if they can do that, they will be playing for a medal tomorrow, whether it's for gold or bronze. Here's Bent with the puck now. He'll play it back to Truin. Truin gets it ahead. That pass goes through Proctor. Actually, no, I saw Rittenberg play. Rittenberg played last year at this level as well. First time I saw him this season was at the Monctonian. Memories start to blur together after a while. As that one ends up going down the length of the ice, and that'll be an icing call against Halifax. When you're calling your 1,000th game, sometimes they start to, you know, blend together and forget which one was what and what was where and who was who. And but it's not about me. It's about these two teams on the ice right now. Storm trying to possibly clinch themselves a first place seeding for the semifinals. They know they will play a semifinal game today. They already have that much guaranteed. With a win Then they'd have to wait for Truro's result in their game against the John L. Jim Cougars. And if the Bearcats also win, then we'd have to look at goal ratios and everything else. There's too many different combinations and permutations of possible results to even talk about just yet, as the Storm end up coming in just a hair offside with 4:42 gone here in period number one. Face-off will be just outside the Halifax blue line. Simonson gets the puck ahead to Sullivan. Sullivan will get it in across the blue line. Now works it down into the near side corner. Plays it up the wall to Bottomley. Back to the line for Girard. He'll send it towards the net. It goes off the stick of Boudreau. And now cleared away from the front of the net by Shoup. Back around to the far side. Sullivan takes a bump there from Boudreau. Puck comes to the line and just out as Simonson couldn't quite get there in time to keep it onside. He'll have to back up all the way into his own zone with it as Warrington is pressuring. Played around to the near side for Girard. He gets it out to center. Bottomley knocked that puck down, but it was a Storm player who touched it next, so player is able to go on. Here's Warrington with it now. He'll get the red line and dump it down into the Halifax end. Bent back to pick up. Under 9.5 to go, first period. Okay. We'll dump it into the Storm zone, but apparently he didn't quite reach the center ice line. Bent trying to argue that he got there, but the lines person saying, nope, you were still on your own side of center. And so that will be an icing call against the Wolverines. Wolverines, as mentioned, with a win, will clinch a spot in the semifinals. If they tie or lose, they will need some help from the Truro Bearcats when the Bearcats play the John L. Jim Cougars in the 12 o'clock game, which will be the final game of the round robin portion of the tournament. Puck is cleared down the ice. That'll be an icing call against the Storm with 6 minutes gone exactly here in the first period. And it'll come down into the Storm zone. It'll be to the left of Will Cole. Again, Cole has played every minute of this tournament for the Storm so far. And has played very, very well, obviously, with a 3-0 record and a save percentage up in the 940s. Bent gets the puck. He'll play it ahead. That's just out of the reach of Proctor. It comes out to center. Dumped right back in again by Creelman. Now on it is Turgeon. He'll play it across to the far side. Bent will work his way ahead. The Halifax captain gets it up to Proctor, who will get it in around the boards. And back to pick up there is Sanford. There's Sanford working her way out across the blue line. Gets the puck poked off of Shearer's stick. He had it momentarily. Now Welsh gets tripped up. And will get the second Storm power play of the morning, as it was Bent who ended up getting his stick just into the feet of River Welsh. And so the tripping call going against Bent with 8:11 left to go here in the first period. We mentioned the Storm power play coming into this game, 1-for-8, so now 1-for-9. The Halifax penalty kill, 9-for-10 coming into this game, so now 10-for-11, so that's 90.9% so far, up from 90% when they came into the game, and the 12.5% down to 11.1%. Here's Aiden O'Donnell with the puck. He takes a bump. The puck comes back to the line. Owen O'Donnell able to get to it there. He'll play it across to Creelman. Creelman sends it towards the net. Rittenberg steers that aside. It comes to the near wall. Back for Aiden O'Donnell again. He takes a bump from Nickel. Back to Owen O'Donnell. There's a shot. Kick save made by Rittenberg. Aiden O'Donnell gets back on it again. He'll play it back to Owen. Across over to Creelman. Creelman with a shot. And Rittenberg makes the save. And this time he will glove it down and hang on for a faceoff. 109 left in the man advantage. 7:20 left to go here in the first period. Want to take a few moments to thank some of the people who need thanks for helping to get me to this milestone game. I know the game isn't about me, but I do need to thank a lot of people, and I will get to them throughout the course of this broadcast. Up here down the ice, Greelman will go back and pick up. Now he'll start to work his way ahead. Over to the near side. Aiden O'Donnell brings it in across the line. Gets away from Curzon. Now tries to make the centering pass. That's broken up by Bottomley. And he will clear it down the ice. Back to get it is Owen O'Donnell. He'll circle behind his net. Now work his way out. Coming up the right side. Now cutting more to the middle of the ice. To the left side. Gets the pass across. That goes just a little bit behind his intended target of McLeod. Aiden O'Donnell able to pick up. Now he'll work it down into the corner. Looking to go cross ice with it. The pass gets deflected. McLeod will get to it. He'll play it down to Aiden O'Donnell in the corner. O'Donnell with the sharp angle shot. Rittenberg to save. And Welsh was there looking for a rebound, but none to be had as Jordan Rittenberg continues to show his great rebound control. 18 seconds left to go in the penalty to Bent, and 6:29 remaining here in the first period. First off, I have to thank my wife, Karen. She's been so good to be so supportive of me through the first 1,000 games. 1,000 down, and how many more? 1,000 to go. Puck comes all the way down the ice. Brenton was actually leading the race to the puck, so Cole had to come out of his net to play it. Got it around the boards to Boudreau. Penalty comes to an end. The puck bounces off of Sullivan's glove and rolls right in onto Rittenberg, so he'll cover it up and hang on for another faceoff. Got to thank some of the great people that I've worked with over the years as well. Matt Little, who was my first full-time partner in broadcasts. Alex Terrio, who has been my regular color commentator for a long time since then. Of course, all my great camera people, including this guy standing beside me right now, Lucas Morton, who has been so great to work with over the years. As another shot and another glove save made by Rittenberg. Takes just a couple more seconds off the clock. And all the teams that I've worked with over the years, my regular teams, including the Pictou County Weeks Crushers, the Weeks U18 Majors, the Wearwell Bombers, the Northern Subway Selects of the Maritime Major Female Hockey League, the team that just joined my regular rotation this year, the U16 AAA Fundy Thunder. So many great teams that I've had a chance to work with over the years to get to this point. And then tournaments like this. You know, a good chunk of my games has been at tournaments like this. Here's Uzuchukwu with a puck now. He has it knocked off his stick momentarily by Rogers. Proctor tries to get it down the boards. Rogers in there helps tie it up, but it'll be picked up by Branton. He'll get it out for Uzuchukwu. There's a shot, but that gets blocked. Now it's back to the line. Tried to play it back down low. That goes off of Nelson and played out to center by Clement. Clements. Now Bent gets his hand up into the face of McLeod, and McLeod with the takedown. And looks like our referee is indicating that both of them are going to go. We'll wait to see the signals here. They each get 4 for head contact, if I read that correctly. So it will stay 5-on-5, I do believe, as Cole McLeod and Cole Bent each get 4 minutes for head contact. Our officials talk it over and they decide the faceoff should stay in the Halifax zone. Bent seems a little incredulous that he's getting a penalty. Bent had the delivered the initial hit and then got wrestled to the ground. So it ends up being coincidental 4-minute double minors for head contact. with 5:11 gone, or 5:11 remaining, excuse me, here in the first period. As these two teams, the Halifax Wolverines and the New Scotland Storm, who of course play out of Cole Harbour, obviously the proximity, these teams know each other quite well. Lopez just holds the puck in at the line. Now Gallant trying to get it back down low, but that's cleared away by Girard. It's out to center. Lopez will dump it right back in again. Truen back to pick up. Back behind his net. Tried to make a pass ahead. That goes off the skate of Aiden O'Donnell. Now Simonson gets it. He'll play it ahead for Shearer. Shearer off the wall, gets it to Lovett. Lovett working his way down the boards. Lopez cleared the pass away, but Shearer following up, gets a shot off. That goes off the blocker of Cole. Now into the corner. Lopez takes Lovett into the wall. Coming in to try to help out for the Wolverines is Benigno. And Benigno will get the puck away from the wall, but not hard enough to get it to Shearer. And it's cleared out down the ice by Creelman. Getting to it. There is Welsh. He'll send it behind the net for Aiden O'Donnell. Knocked off his stick by Truen. Puck comes to the near side. Welsh tries to play it back down to O'Donnell. It does just get through Simonson to O'Donnell. His centering pass for Boudreau ends up deflecting over into the far wall. And Boudreau tried to play it up the boards. That was knocked away by Lovett. Lovett gets it back after Kluwit held it in at the line momentarily. Thomas Kluwit, that is. Now Sanford takes it behind the net. Working away from the forecheck of Shearer. Sanford still with the puck. Now it rolls a little bit too far away from her. Turgeon will get it up the other way, just out of the reach of Benigno. Benigno maybe did get a stick on it enough that it negated the icing. Puck run around the boards. Truen will play it back around to the near side. First one to it there will be Pitcher. He gets it to Bottomley. Bottomley tried to send it back down low. It goes off the skate, comes back to him. Tried to play it back to the line for Turgeon, but that was broken up. Now Boudreau gets the puck all the way down to the end boards. Truen there plays it around the wall. Bottomley gets it to Pitcher. Pitcher plays it off the boards and out to center. Clements back to get it. He plays it off the boards. Turgeon picks up at his own blue line. Plays it ahead to Pitcher. Pitcher leaves it there. Sullivan comes in and picks up the loose puck. Takes it below the goal line. Tries to make a centering pass. Clements got down to block it. Now Sullivan again takes a hit from Sullivan there. Puck comes up the wall. Turgeon holds it in at the line. Gets it back down. Sullivan has it go off his shin pad and all the way out to center. 2:42 left to go here in the first period. There's a shot from Owen O'Donnell. Blocker save made by Rittenberg. Puck cuts all the way to the near side boards. Up the wall to Uzuchukwu off the stick of Turgeon. Uzuchukwu gets tied up by a pair of Storm players. Now the puck towards the net. Sullivan will clear it away from there. Off the wall and out to center. Scotland picks up there and he'll dump it right back into the Halifax zone. Truen picks up along the end boards. Gets it to the near side for Turgeon. Up for Uzuchukwu, who just deflects it out to center. Scotland there with it. Plays it across to the far side. And Creelman tried to get it ahead. Now Proctor delivers a big hit on Welsh as Uzuchukwu comes in and picks up the loose puck. Uzuchukwu across for Proctor. And Proctor couldn't quite get the shot away. By the way, happy birthday to Proctor yesterday. We had a big happy birthday Proctor sign up there yesterday, and it's not up today, so obviously yesterday was the birthday. Puck comes to the line. Lopez will play it across to the far side. Creelman, he fires a shot. Deflection there by Gallant. And Rittenberg able to stay with it. And we have Aiden O'Donnell exchanging pleasantries with Henrik Girard. I'm sure they're talking about how good the restaurants here are in Truro. That's what that conversation was about. One of them was saying they like the Big Stop better. The other one was saying they like Smitty's better. I think that's what that argument was about.
I'm on Team Taco Bell.
You're on Team Taco Bell, yeah. I get that. A lot of really good restaurants here in Truro, I must say. And yes, I've heard that as well, the engine room. But of course, because one of the tournament sponsors is Dairy Queen, maybe we should say that we're saving the best for last and mention Dairy Queen and their sponsorship and thank them very much. And there you go. Gallant ties up with his fellow number 15, That being Girard. Now the puck comes to Lopez. He plays it down into the far corner. Simonson will get it. Gives it to Girard near side as we near the final minute of the first period. Benigno gets bumped off the puck by Boudreau. Boudreau with a shot. And the blocker save made by Rittenberg as he steers it into the near corner. Boudreau couldn't get the puck there as it was sent up over the glass and out of play. And we'll get a stoppage with 52 seconds left in period number one. Storm and Wolverine still looking for the first goal of this game. The longest we went without a goal in a game so far in this tournament was the game that involved Halifax and Bedford last night, as they went just past, I believe it was 8 or 9 minutes into the second period before the first goal of that game, and it ended up in a 2-2 tie. Lopez loses his footing on his way towards the end boards. Uzuchukwu gets the puck. He'll play it up the wall to Bent. Bent sends it back down the boards, but that's knocked down by McLeod. He gets it ahead to Clements. Clements working his way in over for Owen O'Donnell. He couldn't get a shot away, so he backs up with it. Now plays it to Lopez at the line. Lopez with a shot. It hits Bent in front and bounces down to Uzuchukwu. He'll play it over to Proctor. Proctor coming through the neutral zone, gets in across the blue line, but the puck was knocked off his stick just as they got to the blue line, and that was enough to put the Halifax Wolverines offside with just under 10 seconds left to go here in the first period. And as has been the format all weekend long, at the end of this first period, we'll have just a quick couple of minutes of break, and then the switch of ends and go into the second period. After the second, we'll have a full flood, and then the 20-minute third period. No overtime or shootout, as we saw firsthand in yesterday's game between Halifax and Bedford. Shots on goal in that first period. Storm very much in control as they outshot Halifax by a margin of 10-3, but nothing to show for it, as the score at the end of one period, nothing between the Storm and the Wolverines. And while we've got this stoppage here, we'll let you know that the 13th game of the Coltec Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey League Provincial Championship Tournament is sponsored by Wilson's Heating. The tournament itself, some major sponsors to talk about: the gold level sponsor, Coltec Windows and Entrance Systems. Silver level sponsors: Andy's Tire Shop Limited, SBM Offshore, and Maritime Trust Limited. Bronze level sponsors: Motor Hub Automotive Group, Stanfield Limited, Dairy Queen, and Virgil McDougall. As we get ready for the start of the second period here, again, a reminder of what's at stake in this game for the Storm. If they can get the win, then we look at what happens in the Truro versus Jonel Jim Cougars game. And if the Storm and the Bearcats both win, they'll both end up 4-0. And then we look at the tiebreaker scenarios. For the Wolverines, they still need to try and guarantee themselves a spot in the semifinals. The Storm know that they will be playing later today for a semifinal game. The Wolverines still need to get a win to clinch a spot. The best they can finish is fourth. The worst they can finish is fifth. The Gulls, with their victory earlier this morning, can finish no worse than third. The Storm and the Bearcats can finish no worse than third. And if it is a three-way tie at 3-1, then we get into, again, tiebreaker scenarios as to what means what and who plays whom and all kinds of things there. So the Wolverines, it's fourth or bust when it comes to semifinal seedings. And the Jonel Jim Cougars right now are sitting on the outside looking in. They're in fifth place coming into today with their record at 1-2 and the Wolverines at 1-1-1. So the Cougars right now are the Storm's biggest fans. as the Cougars need the Wolverines to tie or lose for the Cougars to have a shot. Here's O'Donnell with the puck. That's Owen O'Donnell. And he'll just play it softly down into the Halifax zone. We'll run through all of the games that we've had so far here very quickly. Thursday, four games on that day. It was the Gulls over Bedford by a score of 10-1. Storm, as we mentioned, opened the tournament with a 5-2 victory over the Novas. Wolverines played their first game in the third game of the day on Thursday, losing that one to the Cougars 4-3. Bearcats beat the Bandits 6-2. Then on Friday, a seven-game day. It was a busy one. Storm opened up the day at 8 a.m. with a 5-1 victory over the Cougars. Bearcats beat the Gulls 6-4 in a thriller. Halifax shut out the Novas 4-0. Storm beat the Bandits 5-2. Then it was the Gulls over the Cougars 4-0. Bearcats beat the Novas 3-2. And then the final game of the day yesterday, Wolverines and Bandits tied at 2. And then the one game earlier today, Gulls beat the Novas 4-1. And yes, there will be a quiz later, so I hope you are all paying attention. Puck is iced by the Wolverines, so we'll get the faceoff down in their zone. It'll come to the right of goaltender Jordan Rittenberg. With 138 gone here in the second period. Aiden O'Donnell wins it back to Creelman. He'll play it across to Lopez for the shot. That comes off the end wall, and Rittenberg able to find it beside his net and cover it up and hang on for another faceoff. And so we'll get the draw this time to Rittenberg's left. As both teams make some changes. The Wolverines are the home team for this game, hence wearing their white jerseys. They also get last change. So they get to do the line matching. That if they are attempting to line match, that's the advantage of being the home team. Storm, with a victory, will be guaranteed of being a home team in a semifinal, as they will finish no worse than second. And again, it would depend on what happens with Truro and how the tiebreakers play out, whether the Storm finish first or second. And I'm not going to go into trying to say anything any further until we get pretty much to the end of the Bearcats versus Cougars game, because there are so many possible scenarios that it's not conducive to try and break them all down. Puck goes off of McLeod's stick out to center. Bent able to get it. He plays it to Truin up for Lovett. Lovett bringing the puck in to the outside, working against Sanford. Takes it all the way down to the corner. Had the puck roll off his stick slightly. Storm able to get it. Plays to the line. Truin able to hold it in there. Plays, gives it to Benigno near side. For Lovett, there's a backhand shot. And Cole, I don't think he was expecting that shot to come in, but was sharp as he made the save. Now Owen O'Donnell coming the other way. He fires a shot. Rittenberg steers that one into the end boards, where it's picked up by Bent. He'll play it across to Truin. Truin gets it ahead to Benigno. Benigno across the line. Goudreau dropped his stick in center ice there. I don't know. I didn't think it. Doesn't look like it got broken. Just as he was working his way through center, stick just came out of his hands, it seems. 11:41 left to go here in the second period. Face off deep in the New Scotland Storm zone. I still end up almost calling them the Cole Harbour Storm, or the Harbour Storm. That's what their name used to be. Puck comes all the way in. Doesn't quite get all the way to Rittenberg before it's batted over to the far wall. Now Bottomley able to take it away from Gallant. Bottomley tries to play it off the boards to himself, but it's intercepted there by Lopez. He'll work his way in across the blue line. Lopez taking it down into the left or right wing corner. Plays it around to the left wing corner for O'Donnell. That being Aiden O'Donnell. Up to the right wing point to Creelman, who sends it below the goal line. Gallant there, but he has it knocked away from him by Simonson. Now Sullivan comes out. He'll play it to Bottomley. Bottomley coming in, trying to split through the D. Able to get through and get a shot away. And the save made by Cole. But as Bottomley tried to split the D, Creelman ended up hooking him. And so we'll get the first Halifax Wolverine power play of the afternoon. Morning. Still morning. Not afternoon yet. Creelman going off for hooking with 10:52 left to go in the second period. And we can tell you now that the Halifax Wolverines so far on the tournament, 2-for-15 on the power play, which works out to 13.3%. Benigno couldn't get a shot away as the puck went off of McLeod skate. He's able to get it out to center. The penalty kill of the Storm right now. This an easy percentage to calculate as they are 13-for-13 on the kill. 13-of-13 successful penalty kills. And here comes O'Donnell into the Halifax zone, but he ends up losing his footing. That'll allow Benigno to pick up the puck and come the other way. Benigno taking it all the way down into the left wing corner. Up in front for Lovett. He couldn't pull the trigger on the shot as his stick was tied up. Now Aiden O'Donnell coming the other way. Cutting into the middle. Gets around Bent. Gets a shot away. And that ends up going wide. O'Donnell not happy that he got held up a little bit there. Laskin, the referee, for a penalty. Not going to get one. Lovett coming in now. He fires a backhand shot. Cole, the save. Rebound. Second save. A third chance. And that one gets blocked by Nelson. Doesn't even get to Cole. Now we're going to get a stoppage as Cole was knocked down. And the referee blew it down as he indicated that Cole was bumped inadvertently, so it was not a penalty, but it was enough to stop the play. 1 minute left to go in the penalty taken by Riley Creelman. 9:52 left to go here in the second period, as we're still looking for the first goal of this game. Branton and Aiden O'Donnell to take this face off. And Uzuchukwu gets his skate in a little too far into the circle, so Branton will get waved out of the faceoff circle. Uzuchukwu will not be allowed to come in and take it. It will be Proctor who takes the draw. O'Donnell able to win it to the near side boards for Sanford, but Sanford can't get it past all the traffic up that wall. Now Truen skating it along the line, able to keep the puck away from O'Donnell and fire it around the boards. Sanford gets to it in the corner, but she's knocked off the puck by Branton. Now Uzuchukwu goes to play it back to Truen at the line, but Truen was a little bit closer to the middle of the ice than Uzuchukwu was anticipating. Now Truen loses his footing in his own zone. Branton ends up overskating the puck as the Wolverines having a little bit of trouble getting themselves out of their zone. Now they come out. Branton picking up speed and gaining momentum as he comes in, tried to fire it around the boards. It was knocked down by Sanford. Branton gets it back again. Now comes all the way back to the line with it, plays it to Truen. Truen goes back down to the half wall for Branton. Branton trying to get away from Sanford. Sanford able to steal the puck, get it off the wall and to the line, but not out. Nice play by Truen to keep it onside, but just 7 seconds left in the power play now. In front, that'll be cleared away by Lopez. Lopez coming out, he's got Gallant. That pass just out of Gallant's reach. But Gallant will get to it before it reaches the goal line. So not an icing, although it wouldn't have been anyway as the penalty hadn't quite expired yet. Now Branton coming the other way. Getting back was Rogers, but Branton able to score. Rogers gave him a bump just as he got the shot away. And Max Branton puts the Halifax Wolverines out in front. With 6:20 gone here in the third period, it is 1-0. And for Branton, that is, let me just pull it up here. Where is he? There he is. His second goal, third point of the tournament. Angus Proctor gets the lone assist on that one. Pitcher gets bumped off the puck there by Creelman. So that goal, once again, Max Branton, his second goal, third point of the tournament. Now here comes Aiden O'Donnell coming the other way. O'Donnell with the move, and he scores! So the Wolverines carry the lead for a grand total of 24 seconds before Aiden O'Donnell ties it back up. And Aiden O'Donnell gets his first goal and fifth point of the tournament. I was still looking down, double-checking something, so I didn't see who passed it up to him. We'll wait for the call on the assist there. Welsh with the assist. And now a beautiful save by Cole. So those two goals again, because they came so quickly. Max Branton, his second goal, third point, assisted by Angus Proctor at 6:20. Then at 6:34, just 14 seconds later, or 24 seconds later, excuse me. It was Aiden O'Donnell, his first goal, fifth point, assisted by River Welsh to tie up the game at one. And 24 seconds of lead for the Halifax Wolverines. Gone almost as quickly as it came. Here's Bent with the puck now. Gets it down into the corner, gets past Lovett, comes all the way to the near side wall for Shearer. Shearer on the left wing boards. Had three Storm players around him, ended up losing the puck there as a result. Now here's McLeod. He's got Owen O'Donnell heading to the net. And McLeod tried to play it to O'Donnell. Simonson got a stick on it, but he ended up putting it onto the stick of O'Donnell, who was able to get a shot away, and Rittenberg sharp with that one as he makes his 13th save on 14 shots so far. And you really can't fault Rittenberg for the one that he had get by him, as Aiden O'Donnell with a beautiful deep move. And you really can't fault Will Cole for the one that got by him, as it was a perfect shot far side by Max Branton. Now in the corner, Shoop, he can't get his stick on the puck as Lovett gets it. He'll play it out for Shearer. Shearer has Bonino with him. Shearer takes the puck down all the way to the goal line and ran out of room before he could make a play. Now we're going to get a penalty against Nelson. They're going to call Nelson for hooking. We have 6:52 left to go in the period, so the Wolverines will get their second power play of the game. And it is Cole Nelson going off into the box. So the Wolverines with a chance to reclaim the lead that they had. They scored their goal just 12 seconds after their first power play expired. Sullivan with the puck, plays it to Truin at the near side. He'll get it down to Uzuchuku at the boards. Skates it up now across the far side for Branton. Branton steps in, fans on a shot attempt, and that allows Aiden O'Donnell to come the other way. He's got Gallant with him. O'Donnell to Gallant, and what a save by Rittenberg! Just getting a piece of it with his glove. Great pass by O'Donnell to set up Gallant, but Rittenberg comes across and gets the glove on it. Doesn't make the clean catch, but it doesn't matter. He keeps the puck out of his net. Now Truin in the corner, working against Creelman. Truin takes another bump from Creelman. Puck comes loose. Gallant gets it as far as the line. Uzuchuku keeps it in. Truin deflects Uzuchuku's shot. Second chance, and what a save by Cole! As the diving shot leads to a diving save. What a save by Cole at one end. What a save at the other end by Rittenberg moments earlier. Now another nice save against O'Donnell. And the pass gets deflected out to center. And it'll be sent back down into the Halifax zone. Back down again into the Storm end. McLeod plays it off the boards. That ended up hitting some Halifax players as they were making a change. Storm wanted a too many players penalty. And I don't know, I think they might have had a case. Here's Lopez with the puck now. Battle in the corner there. Lopez trying to keep it tied up as the penalty clock on Cole Nelson continues to click away. Now it's worked free finally. And Proctor will work his way ahead. 15 seconds left in the penalty. Gets the puck to Bonino. Bonino tries to get it through. It does come through to Lovett, but he couldn't get the puck to sit properly for him to get a shot away. Now coming over, getting it, Shearer. His pass for Bonino, just a little bit out of his reach as it went off the heel of his stick. Now Bonino across for Shearer. Shearer gets it back across for Lovett. And another great save by Cole. Puck goes up into the air, comes down near corner. Shearer back to the line for Bent. It hops past him. Now race for the puck. And McLeod ends up picking it up after both Bent and Owen O'Donnell overskated it. It comes out to center. Kluwit will play it back in. That's Thomas Kluwit who sent it back in. Here's Lovett with the puck now. We are back to 5-on-5, by the way. While all of that furious action was going on, we did have the penalty come to an end. Now Shearer with a shot. And I think that was blocked by Sanford. Puck comes to the line. Turgeon, he'll send it down to Shearer. Shearer tries to get it to the front of the net. That was knocked down by Sanford. And McLeod will come the other way with it. He feeds it to Clements. Clements sending it down into the Halifax zone. With 4 minutes left to go, second period. Tie hockey game 1-1. Here's Benigno working his way ahead. He gets the puck flipped down into the Storm zone. It took a bounce out of the corner that it never actually reached the goal line. Now Girard will play it to Simonson as it comes into the Halifax zone. Simonson's pass goes off of Warrington's leg, comes back to Simonson. Now Bottomley will get it out to center. Shoup tries to dump it back in, ended up hitting his own player Warrington with it. Nickel able to pick up the puck, gets around Scotland. Nickel loses his footing, tried to make a pass, but Shoup able to knock that one away. Now it's back to Girard at the line. His shot. And pitcher was looking for a deflection, but couldn't get the redirect. And the puck comes in onto Cole, and he'll make the save and hang on for a faceoff. 3:21 remaining here in period number two, tied up at a goal apiece. I gotta say, out of the games that we've had in this tournament, it has been very entertaining, very good hockey all weekend long. And I'm not saying that because I'm surprised by it, because I'm not. I'm just saying it that as a fact, this has been a great weekend of hockey, and we still have the rest of this game, one more round robin game, two semifinals, and a couple of medal games left to go. Yeah. As Lucas was just saying here, I don't know if you were able to hear him or not, even the games that had slightly larger deficits never felt like they were big one-sided games. Even we had one game that ended up being a 9-goal margin, and even that one really didn't feel like a 9-goal game. It felt very competitive all the way through. Just one team got all the bounces in that game. Lopez plays the puck up the wall. Branton gets it back, plays it into the Storm zone, but Lopez was right there, knocks it down, gets it to Creelman. Creelman will get it across to Aiden O'Donnell, who launches a blast, and Rittenberg makes the blocker save, and it goes up over the glass. Now to play, we'll get a stop. 2:15 to go here in period number two. And if anyone from the Halifax and Storm organizations, upper organizations, are watching, just to let you guys know, after the game, I know that the tournament itself is using online scoring, but I write out my own game sheets so that I've got the rosters right in front of me as I'm calling the game, and I fill in the score sheet as if I were doing the scoring down in the penalty box. And because this is my 1,000th game, there's a shot from Turgeon. I am going to be heading downstairs after the game ends, hoping to get all of the players from both teams to sign this sheet, as it is my 1,000th game. So if anybody from either of the organizations is watching and you want to give your coaches a heads up that I'm going to be doing that. There's O'Donnell with a shot. Rittenberg got a piece of it, and then I think it went off of iron as well. Couldn't quite tell for sure, but it certainly looked that way. Now here comes Benigno the other way. Another shot, and that one off the mask of Cole. As our two goaltenders here are having a whale of a game. Rittenberg and Cole. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you. As they go back and forth, matching each other save for save. Cole, as one of the sports highlight show hosts on that big three-letter network that covers sports likes to say, that's using your face. Here's Aiden O'Donnell now coming in. His shot gets deflected by Gerard, and it ends up going wide and then bounces up over the glass and out of play, and we'll get another stoppage. 1 minute exactly left to go here in the second period. And I don't know what Creelman was jawing with Gerard about, but talked Gerard all the way back to his bench. Now we're going to have a conversation. The puck was clearly deflected, so if the conversation is about where the faceoff should be, it should definitely be in the Halifax zone. Branton wins the draw against Aiden O'Donnell. Able to get the puck around to the near side. Truen will get it off the boards and out to center. Creelman going back to get it, but Branton gets a step on him. Branton for Uzuchukwu, but O'Donnell tied up his stick enough to deny him from getting a shot away. Now it's played out to center. Bent tries to get it back towards the storm zone. O'Donnell feeds O'Donnell. That was Aiden giving the puck to Owen, who played it around the boards to McLeod. McLeod tried to get it past Truen. Truen gets it to Uzuchukwu, who gets it as far as the line, held in there by Lopez, who fires a shot. And now Bent will get it out, and it'll roll just wide of the net. No icing. And now with 17 seconds left, McLeod tries to go cross ice with the pass. It's broken up by Uzuchukwu. He'll play it off the boards. Back out to center. Backed up to Creelman. He'll get it ahead. And Owen O'Donnell gets it to McLeod. McLeod kicks it forward, but it was an offside. And then after the whistle, Branton ends up bumping with McLeod, and McLeod goes down. 3.3 seconds remain here in the second period. And it looks like we will go into the second intermission the way we came into the second period with the game tied. The only difference is after one, it was tied at goose eggs. After two, it's tied at straight lines. And so we'll go to the third period with the game tied a goal apiece. Shots on goal in that period were heavily in favor of the Wolverines after it was heavily in favor of the Storm in the first period. Wolverines outshot the Storm 15-7 in that period after 10-3 for the Storm in the first. So you put those numbers together and it is 18-17 for the Wolverines after two periods of play. We're going to take a break. We'll come back, get you ready for the third period. We'll talk about the sponsors when we come back as well, because they deserve their support. It is 1-1 after two periods of play here in game number 13 of the 2023 Coltec Nova Scotia Under 15 Major Hockey Provincial Championship Tournament here on AO Live through Atlantic Hockey Online, produced by Petter Sports and Streaming. Thanks so much for watching. We'll be back with you in just a few minutes.
Yes, I'm just, you know, proud moment. It's more about me wanting to thank everybody who's helped me get here, not about me going, look at me, I did a thousand years.
Welcome back as we get ready for the third period here. 1-1 the score between the Wolverines and the Storm. As the Storm with a victory would, actually, the Storm with a tie would clinch no worse than second place. The Storm with a win would still clinch no worse than second place. They'd have to wait for the outcome of the Truro Bearcats game against the John L. Jim Cougars. The Wolverines, with a win, would clinch fourth place. With a tie, would need the Cougars to either tie or lose their game against the Bearcats. And the Wolverines, if they end up losing, would need the Cougars to lose their game against Truro. If the Storm lose this game, they would finish in a tie with the Gulls. And then it would depend on what happens with Truro, whether it's a two-way tie or a three-way tie. And then we look at what the tiebreakers are based on that, and it's all very complex. But the bottom line is we have 20 minutes left in this game, which is a tie game. We have one more game left after that. And only after all of that is done can we say with any sort of certainty what the semifinal matchups are going to be. Just exchanging messages with my wife during the intermission there. One of the players for the Gulls, I mentioned it, I think at one point in one of the Gulls games, that one of the players might be a cousin of my wife's, and so I just asked her, so how exactly are you guys related? And she sent back to me, well, we don't know for sure. We just know that the player's mom's maiden name is the same as my wife's maiden name, and there aren't that many families with that name in Nova Scotia. So they know they're related somewhere along the line, but how exactly it is, they're not sure. But so, yeah, so one of my wife's distant cousins is in the tournament here, which puts a bit of a different perspective on it. Truin with the puck down in his own zone. Plays it around to Bent. He'll get it ahead for Proctor. And Proctor plays it off the boards out to center. Creelman will gather it in there off the glass. And back out to center again. Now O'Donnell trying to work the puck ahead, but he couldn't. Proctor will pick it up, bring it back into the storm zone. Proctor with a shot. That goes off the leg of Creelman into the near side boards. Branton will take it down to the corner. He takes a bump from Lopez, but is able to follow the puck over to the far side. Gets it back to the line for Bent. His shot goes off the skate of Welsh, or the stick of Welsh, excuse me. Now into the near side corner. Branton able to pick up there. Sends it back down to the corner for Proctor. Proctor takes a bump from Aiden O'Donnell, and that allows Lopez to get the puck and send it down the ice. Truin back to pick up in his own end. 56 seconds gone in the period. Ahead for Proctor. He'll get it around the boards. And Lovett gets there about the same time Sanford does. Lovett able to get the puck poked back down below the goal line. Clements around to the far side. And now bringing the puck out. Clements sends it into the Halifax zone. Turgeon knocks it down. Gets it all the way down into the corner. Picked up there by McLeod. His pass intended for Clements. Broken up by Shearer. Now here comes Shearer working down the right wing. Shearer cutting to the middle. And he gets taken down there. We're not going to see a penalty called. Thought there might have been one as Shearer was taken down. Now Owen O'Donnell will get it across to McLeod. Clements trailing. McLeod gets the shot away. That's blocked by Simonson. Puck comes around to the near side, and Bedinho will get it out to center. That'll get beyond everybody. Icing gets waved off. And now we're going to get a penalty against Shearer as he hauled down Rogers. Sanford waiting with the puck. That's not Sanford. That's 20, not 12. My apologies. That was Scotland had the puck behind the net. Now gets it ahead to McLeod. Cole out of the net for the extra attacker with the delayed penalty coming up. Gallant will get the puck across the line. Fire a shot. Rittenberg has that go off his blocker into the near side wall. Scotland takes it down to the corner. And as they tie up in that corner, Sullivan gets the puck and will get the stoppage. And I believe it's going to be a holding call. No, it's going to be a head contact call against Shearer. So the Wolverines will be shorthanded for the third time here this morning. This one coming with 2.5 minutes gone in the third period. So the Storm, who are 0-for-2 with the power play so far in this game, get their third chance. And as this third power play starts, Creelman gets a shot away. That's off the blocker of Rittenberg. McLeod back to Creelman. Tried to play it back down to McLeod. He wasn't expecting it. And Bent gets to the puck in the corner, but he's tied up and coming out from the corner with it as well. She goes short side and finds the tiniest of openings to put the puck past Rittenberg, and it is 2-1. What a snipe by River Welsh, as it didn't look like there was much space there at all, but Welsh was able to find it. And he gets his second point of this game, his sixth goal and 8th point of the weekend. And what a goal it was for River Welsh. He came out of the corner with the puck himself, found the tiniest bit of empty space, and was able to beat Rittenberg blocker side 20 seconds into the man advantage. Cole McLeod gets an assist for helping to work the puck free down in that corner. Now pitcher has it in center ice. He'll play it back to Truen. Truen up the boards for Bottomley. Bottomley trying to get away from Sanford. He's able to get it ahead for Sullivan. Sullivan has pitcher heading towards the net. Try to get the pass to pitcher, but it goes off of Thomas Kluet. And then comes to the near side wall. Truen not able to hold the puck onside as it just came out. And Truen, in his frustration, ends up firing the puck down the ice. Referee having a little word with him about that. As understandable the frustration there, but can't get away with those kinds of things. So the ref does let him off with a warning. Truen gets the puck and fires it down into the zone. Cole couldn't stop the puck. Did slow it down enough. Proctor got to it in the corner, but he lost it to Creelman. Plays it up the wall. Bent keeps it in. Couldn't get it past Welsh. Now Creelman will play it off the boards. It comes to Proctor. Proctor can't get a shot away. Creelman tied up his stick. And Welsh will get the puck. Come out to center with it. Here's Aiden O'Donnell taking it down into the corner. He gets taken to the boards by Truen. O'Donnell still with it. Now he'll come to the corner. Back for Gallant. That pass just a little bit beyond him. Gallant battling with Bent. Bent able to fire it around the wall. Proctor will get to it, and he uses the boards to play it up into the storm zone. Lopez back on it. He'll play it to the near side for Gallant, who will bring it back into the Halifax end. That shot off the blocker of Rittenberg, and up over the glass and out of play. We'll get a stoppage with 4:22 remaining here in period number three. Or 4:22 gone, excuse me, in period number three. If this score holds, Storm will finish no worse than second. And this result would also guarantee that the Gulls finish third. And I can say that much because if Truro wins, then the Gulls would be the only team at 3-1. Truro and the Storm would both be 4-0. If the Bearcats tie their game, Storm would be first at 4-0, Bearcats would be second at 3-0-1, and the Gulls would be third at 3-1. And if the Bearcats lose their game, Storm would be 4-0, Bearcats and Gulls would both be 3-1. However, the Gulls' loss was against the Bearcats, and therefore the Bearcats would finish ahead of the Gulls based on the head-to-head tiebreaker, so the Gulls would finish third. So if the Storm win this game, the Gulls will finish third. That much we know. Everything else is still up in the air, but if the Storm hold on and win this game, Gulls finish third. Here's Lovett with the puck. Of course, there's still just under 15 minutes left to go in this game, and a lot of things can change between now and the end of the game. I'm saying if the Storm hold on. Puck down the ice. Boudreau trying to get to it before it reaches the goal line, but doesn't quite get there. It was incredibly close. Great hustle by Boudreau, but not quite able to get there in time. And so the faceoff will come all the way back down into the Storm zone with 5:29 gone in the third period. Faceoff will be to the left of goaltender Will Cole. Granton wins it back to Turgeon. Turgeon with a shot. Save made by Cole, and he's able to kick it over to the far wall. Owen O'Donnell gets it up to McLeod. McLeod brings it into the Halifax zone. Gets it down deep below the goal line. Bent ends up getting it to the front of his own net. Clements there ties up with Branton. And Proctor able to get the puck out to center. Lopez gathers it in at his own line. He'll play it forward. Turgeon Gets it up to Uzuchukwu. Uzuchukwu ends up losing it to Lopez. Lopez gets tripped up by Turgeon. And we're going to get another penalty against the Wolverines here. McLeod will take the puck all the way back down toward his own zone as Cole gets out of the net for the extra attacker. Creelman plays it to O'Donnell. Back over to Creelman. 6-on-5. Pass over to Clements. Gets it to McLeod. McLeod couldn't get a shot away as Bent got a piece of his stick. And now as Uzuchukwu touches the puck, we'll get the penalty against Turgeon. And I believe they're going to call it tripping. And that is indeed the call. So Christopher Turgeon going off for the trip here with 13:34 to go in the third period. The Storm now 1-for-3 on the power play in this game, which puts them to 2-for-11 on the tournament. Puck played with a high stick, and so now when Owen O'Donnell touches the puck, that'll bring the faceoff to the New Scotland Storm end as it was knocked down with the high stick on, or knocked with the high stick on its way down the ice. And to me, that always seems to be a no-win play. If the puck's going over your head and you deflect it with your high stick, at best, the other team gets possession as play goes on. At worst, you have to have a face-off back in your own zone as the puck gets beyond your high stick and all the way down the ice. I understand that it's instinct. You know, you see the puck coming over your head, you do something to try and stop it. And I don't know how you would fight against that instinct. Creelman coming through the middle of the ice was looking for a tripping call there as Bent got him, was able to take him down. Back to get the puck is Owen O'Donnell. He'll carry it ahead here with 1:09 left to go in the man advantage. Comes through a couple of Halifax defenders. Now plays it back to the line for Aiden O'Donnell. Across to Creelman. Creelman with a shot. That's blocked by Bent. Puck ends up on the stick of McLeod. Over for Owen O'Donnell. His shot. And Rittenberg able to steer that one away. Now Bottomley. Able to fire it down the length of the ice. Cole will set the puck up there for Creelman. Creelman will go behind his own net. Now come out. Long lead pass intended for O'Donnell. Branton got a piece of that puck. Corner. Here's Creelman with the puck again as he works his way forward with it. Gets it over to the far side for McLeod. McLeod to O'Donnell. Branton there to help tie that one up, and then Simonson will get it down the ice with 13 seconds left in the penalty to Turgeon. Creelman coming through center. Gains the red line, gains the blue line, takes it to the right wing side, fires a shot. It comes all the way to the left wing boards. Now O'Donnell with a shot, and Rittenberg makes the save and hangs on. With 8:31 gone here in the third period, Storm leading it 2-1. The goal that is the difference right now, the power play goal by River Welsh at 2:50 of the third period. That gave the Storm their lead, trying to finish off the round robin with a 4-0 record. Again, it's an incomplete round robin, which is how you can have two teams end up tied at 4-0. Because obviously they did not play against each other through the course of the tournament. Here's Shearer with the puck. He'll bring it in. Has Lovett and Benigno with him. Shearer still with it. Takes it all the way down into the corner. Gets taken into the boards by Clements. Now Lovett gives it back to Shearer. Shearer looking to get it to Benigno, but that pass just to the wrong side of him. Simonson with a shot, and that goes wide. Puck comes up the wall to Turgeon. He'll play it back down towards the corner for Shearer. Shearer trying to protect the puck along the boards. Lovett comes in to pick it up from him. Benigno with a shot, and another save made by Cole, and he will hang on for a faceoff. As again, both of these goaltenders having a very good game today. Will Cole, now with 19 saves on 20 shots. At the other end, Jordan Rittenberg, 22 saves on 24 shots. Branton in to take this faceoff against Aiden O'Donnell. O'Donnell plays it into the corner to Kielman. He gets it up the wall, held in at the line by Bent. Now Branton tried to kick the puck over to one of his teammates, but it ends up coming out to center. Truen will play it back in after the Wolverines touch up. They get the pressure in on Lopez. Anuza Chukwu creates the turnover, sends it behind the net. Kielman will get it around to the far side, and that's played out to center. But Bent again dumps it right back in. Kielman now able to get the puck ahead. Long lead pass intended for Welsh. It was touched by a Wolverine on the way by, so no icing. Welsh gets it to the front of the net. It's still loose. Truen able to kick it away to the corner as the puck was dangerously just lying there at the top of the crease. Now it's sent down into the storm zone. Cole will steer it towards the near corner, and Lopez ends up playing it to the front of his own net, and Cole has to jump on it and make the smother for a faceoff just past the midway point of this third period. Again for the Wolverines, looking at how the score stands right now. If this result holds, the Wolverines would need a loss from the Cougars or possibly a tie. If the Cougars and the Bearcats tie, then both the Wolverines and the Cougars would both have records of 1-2-1. They would not have played each other. Or no, they did play each other, and the Cougars beat the Wolverines. So the Cougars, or the Wolverines, would need the Cougars to lose if they do not come back and at least tie this game. Puck played out to center. Sanford dumps it back in. Rittenberg settles it beside the net for Simonson. Simonson now will come out the right side of the net. Ends up fanning on his pass attempt. Justin Kluet picked up the puck, but then got leveled by Turgeon. It was a clean hit. Got to point that out. Now Shearer with a shot. And where's the puck? No goal, says the referee. The Wolverines are celebrating, but the referee who was down at the goal line waved it off. From up here, I couldn't tell you for sure whether that puck actually crossed the line or not, so I'm going to defer to the referee who was standing there. So the announcement by the referee is that it was no goal. The puck did not cross the line. Now our officials are going to talk it over just to make sure. The Wolverine bench wants to hear it face to face from the referee who was down there. And like I say, he was in much better position to make that call than I was from up here. I lost sight of the puck. The referee did not, apparently. And he said that Cole was able to keep it out of the net, so it remains 2-1 for the Storm. Down under 9 minutes left to go here in the third period. Puck comes around the wall. Bent fires a shot, save made by Cole. Proctor able to pick it up there. He'll send it behind the net for Uzuchukwu. Chike Uzuchukwu ends up losing it to Gallant. Gallant gets it out. That pass just beyond the reach of Welsh, and Bent will send it back into the Storm zone. It comes all the way around the boards to the near side. Lopez takes a hit from Proctor. Uzuchukwu able to get the puck to Proctor. He'll send it around behind the net. Kielman will get there first. Fire it up the far wall for Welsh. And Welsh will work his way down the right wing side against Bent. And that's going to be an offside against the Storm, as Bent just slowed Welsh up enough that Gallant ended up going in a step early. And we get the offside with 8:14 left to go here in the third period. Face-off will be on the right-wing side from a Storm perspective, left-wing side for the Halifax team, just outside the Wolverine blue line. Lovett won it back, but the first player on it was McLeod. McLeod coming in, gets a shot, and Rittenberg makes the save off of his face with that one. Now Bonino coming the other way, tries to feed it through for Shearer. And that was knocked by Lopez, and that was enough to create an offside situation against the Wolverines. And we're going to get a slashing penalty here against McLeod. That must have happened behind the play, because I didn't see that. Mind you, I didn't see McLeod. I was watching Benigno and Lopez. So with 8:01 left to go in the third period, the Wolverines get their third power play of the game. They are 0-2 on the game. They are now 2-17 on the tournament, which 2-17 is just a little bit under 12%. There's a shot, save made by Cole. Puck comes back to Benigno. He'll give it to Bent. Near side, Lovett. Lovett gets it through, looking back door for Shearer, but that was just a little bit out of his reach. Now Benigno tied up by Owen O'Donnell. Creelman trying to come in to help out, as does Shearer. Shearer will get it back to the line for Bent. Near side, Lovett. Lovett will play it back to the line for Bent. Bent fires it off the end boards to Benigno. Benigno comes near side with it for Lovett. Lovett fires a shot from the top of the faceoff circle. Looked like it was going wide, but Will Cole, not taking any chances, gloves it down and hangs on with 1:07 left to go in the penalty to Cole McLeod and 7:08 remaining here in period number three. Apparently, I can't imagine it's a player's 17th birthday, with this being the U15 league. Maybe those balloons there are for number 17? Cole McLeod, perhaps? I don't know. Or maybe it's the birthday of an older sibling turning 17. Bent with the puck. Down to Uzuchukwu. Back to Bent again. Skates along the line. Now gives to Branton. Branton at the top of the faceoff circle, taking a look at his options. Goes far side with it. Uzuchukwu now skating towards the middle of the ice. Gives to Bent with a one-timer. That goes just wide. Uzuchukwu able to pick it up after it rebounds off the end boards. Down to Proctor in the corner. Proctor will skate it up the wall. Now give to Uzuchukwu. Near side looking for Branton, but just getting his stick in the way of that, or her stick in the way of that, was Claire Sanford. Now puck brought back in by Uzuchukwu. Fires a shot, and Cole makes the save and hangs on. 6:14 to go, third period, 13 seconds left in the penalty. And the faceoff will be to which side? It'll be to the right of goaltender Will Cole. Lovett and Owen O'Donnell, to take this draw. Storm win the faceoff and are able to push the puck out all the way down the ice. Truen will go back and get it. 6 seconds left in the power play. So that will pretty much bring the man advantage to an end and will bring us down to the final 6 minutes of regulation. Bent goes to play the puck ahead. It was knocked down. Now Clements gets it up to Owen. Puck play back out across the line, dumped back in again. Rittenberg slows that down as it comes to the near side corner. Truen will get to it there. Plays it ahead, intended for Benigno, broken up by Clements. Now Benigno coming out. Takes the puck in across the blue line. Down towards the corner, goes to make a drop pass. Bent just able to keep it onside, gets it across to the near side for Simonson, but he couldn't take it cleanly. Clements coming out the other way. Clements with a shot, and that goes just wide of the far post. Chasing the puck down and getting to it is Lovett. He gets taken into the boards by Thomas Kluwit, and that'll allow Sanford to pick up the puck. Claire Sanford gets it ahead all the way out to Boudreaux. Boudreaux has it knocked away from him by Lovett, who sends it back down into the Cole Harbour zone, and Sanford has to go back and pick up as we reach 5 minutes remaining in regulation. Sanford out from behind the net. Runs into the broken stick that was left on the ice there, but able to keep going and dumps the puck down into the Halifax zone. Rittenberg out of the net, settles the puck there for Turgeon. Christopher Turgeon working his way forward. Gets it up to Bottomley. MJ Bottomley gets the pass across for Sullivan with a shot and the save made by Cole. 25th save of the morning for Will Cole as he continues to be stellar in the Storm cage. Bottomley now with the puck. Storm cage. That sounds like something out of the Hunger Games, maybe. Puck goes. Weird where the brain goes sometimes. 4:11 left to go here in the third period. 2-1 for the Storm as they try to hang on and get a 4-0 record. And then they'll have to wait and see what the Bearcats do, and it'll all come down to the goal ratio. And again, I'm not going to give any indication on any of the math of that, even though I am a math teacher. I misread the tiebreaker rules last year and ended up saying the semifinal matchups incorrectly. So I'm not going to make that mistake. I'll just tell you that if the Bearcats win and both teams end up 4-0, that a tiebreaker will apply based on goal ratio because they won't have a head-to-head meeting to look at. Obviously, since they both would have 4-0 records, there's no way they could do that if they had a head-to-head game. Truen, his shot blocked by Creelman. Creelman will get it back out to center. Truen gloves it down and sends it back in deep. 3.5 minutes left to go. Still plenty of time, so the net of Jordan Rittenberg not about to get emptied anytime soon, but another 2 minutes or so, and we'll have to start looking for whether Rittenberg comes out of the cage. Here's Bench with the puck now, getting away from Aiden O'Donnell, but Owen O'Donnell gets to the puck, sends it back down below the goal line. Truen will pick up there, plays it off the boards and out to center. Clements goes to dump it back in. It gets knocked down. Now Clements plays it to the middle of the ice. Bent able to pick it up, and he'll get it to Benigno. It hops over his stick. Sanford sending it the other way, but that's kicked down by Shearer. Now the loose puck. Truen gets it over to Shearer. Shearer able to get it back to Truen. Truen trying to split through the D, but Sanford able to send him over into the far wall. Benigno now out front for Lovett, and what a save by Cole. Oh, my goodness. Somehow Cole got that left leg back far enough to get a toe on that puck and keep his team in front by a goal. 2:15 left here, third period. Will Cole has been spectacular. Benigno, sharp angle shot. It ends up going all the way through the crease and out to center ice. Now backing it up, Simonson in his own zone. He'll get the pass across to Shearer. Shearer lost it to Kluwit. Shearer able to get it back, plays it in to the Storm zone. Creelman will just back up and kill off a few more seconds. Now he'll launch it down the ice. Glove down by Simonson at his own blue line. And Lovett will pick up the puck and come in to the Storm end. Lovett tries to get a pass across. Too many Storm players in the way. And it's launched back out. Turgeon hustling back, gets to it and plays it off the wall to Simonson before Aiden O'Donnell could get there. Now a pass across for Shearer. Here comes Shearer, 84 seconds left. Keeping half an eye on Rittenberg. He's not leaving the net yet. Puck goes down into the corner. Lovett will play it around to the far side for Shearer. Gallant able to pick up. Gallant gives to Creelman. Creelman will fire it around the boards to the far side. Welsh gets it there. As we reach 1 minute remaining, puck down into the Halifax zone. Back to get it is Turgeon. Turgeon, pass ahead for Proctor. Proctor in across the blue line. Out comes Rittenberg for the extra attacker. There's a shot. Steered aside by Cole. Branton gets it to the front of the net. Bouncing puck. Sullivan can't get a stick on it. Proctor does. He turns and fires. That goes into the end glass. 40 seconds left to go. Uzuchukwu plays it back to the line for Bent. Bent with a shot. That's knocked down in front. And it'll be cleared out to center by Creelman. 31 seconds left to go. Bent picks up the puck in his own end. They have to hurry. Here's Uzuchukwu with the puck. He'll bring it in across the line. That pass goes just a little bit behind Proctor. And it'll be an offside as the puck just came out, apparently, says the Lions person who was right there. And so we'll get a stoppage. 22.2 seconds left to go here in the third period. And the Wolverines are going to take their time out to try and set something up to see if they can time or they can tie up this game. 22.2 seconds they have to work with to try and get a tie. If this score holds, again, the Wolverines would need Truro to defeat the Cougars. Any other result, a tie or a Cougar win, would eliminate the Wolverines and give the Cougars the fourth and final semifinal spot. If the Wolverines can get a tying goal here, then the Wolverines would advance with a Cougar loss or a Cougar tie. For the Storm, if they can hold on to the victory, they will finish no worse than second. Truin tries to get a pass across D to D. That's broken up by O'Donnell, and O'Donnell will fire the puck into the empty net, and that will seal the victory for the Storm. Aiden O'Donnell with his second goal of the game into the empty net with 16.7 seconds remaining. And now the Halifax Wolverines need to become Bearcats fans for the next couple of hours, as their fate will lie in the hands of the Truro Bearcats. And the outcome of the game between the Bearcats and the Cougars. Here's Owen O'Donnell bringing the puck back in. Aiden O'Donnell's goal, of course, unassisted. One final save by Rittenberg. Puck gets to the line. Lopez will send it back in deep, and that will do it for this one. The New Scotland Storm with a 3-1 victory over the Halifax Wolverines. They have clinched at least second, possibly first, depending on the outcome of the Bearcats game. The Wolverines have to wait at their fate in the hands of the Truro Bearcats and the John L. Jim Cougars. We'll get the presentation of the players of the game. Aiden O'Donnell with a three-point effort, two goals and an assist. River Welsh with a goal and an assist. Will Cole with 27 saves on 28 shots. Sanford played very well on the back end. Boudreau had a good game. For the Wolverines, a lot of players you could talk about for them. And it is going to be Will Cole for the Storm. For the Wolverines, Rittenberg, 24 saves on 26 shots. I thought Benigno played well. I thought Uzuchukwu played well. Proctor. And Will Shearer had a great game as well. So those are your players of the game. Will and Will, Cole and Shearer. And that will do it for this one. For the 1,000th time, on behalf of my awesome cameraman, Lucas Morton, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score once again, the New Scotland Storm with a 3-1 victory over the Halifax Wolverines. Thanks so much for watching. We will be back with you in about half an hour for our next game, the final game of the round robin between the John L. Jim Cougars and the Truro Bearcats. Until then, enjoy the rest of your Saturday morning.